Welcome back to Outings with the Delver. Last time, we cleared several rooms in the tooled shed, but I think we still have a little bit more left to do, and it's possible that these rooms might be harder than the others. Although, actually, I'd say the difficulty level's been fairly consistent so far. This seems to have been pretty consistently like a seven-brain hold or so. Maybe seven and a half. I don't know. It's a little bit hard to tell. It'll be more obvious after we've played a few holds. Now, what's going on here? It seems like we need something that can break a wall. Something that can destroy a mirror, I guess, or push it. Or, wait a second, what's that gonna do? Yeah, it needs to still be alive after that. So, maybe spear then? Well, hold on a second. It needs to be able to push it that way. Like, I need to be able to... Yeah, I need to be able to push it like that. So it can't be that. But I already used pickaxe. And pickaxe can't do this move, so that rules that out. So I think it might actually be just be really big sword. I think this might actually be the really big sword room. I think we found it at last. Oh, hello there.
I think I see what's going on here. Well, first of all, we've got some guards to take care of. I think we probably don't need them for anything. But how are we going to survive this opening combat here? This is very inconvenient. I was not expecting this kind of scenario in this hole, to be perfectly honest with you. Alright, so now we're out. Let's see what that scroll says. I bet it's a challenge scroll. Okay, do not allow any water skippers to step on a force arrow. Like, for example, this one, right here. So if I understand correctly, I believe the format of this room is I need to put these three swords on these three tokens. Because I need to be able to, at the very end of the room, I'm going to close this out, open these. This is the only way for anything to get in there, so I need these mimics to swap their sticks for a sword so they can kill the eyes. That is a clever mechanism. Of course, the problem with that is I need to clear things out sufficiently to such an extent that I can bring a stick all the way from here to the sword without getting overwhelmed. So, for starters, I might have to do this. This could actually be a big problem if this fills up too quickly. I might actually need to do that right away. Oh, and of course there's a spider in there, naturally. So yeah, I kind of feel like that was necessary. I think the only reason I survived that was because the roaches weren't to me yet. Alright, so we can do that whenever we want. There's already a water skipper on that force arrow. Because that filled up fast. Like, this already filled up to such an extent that water skipper went there, and it went on that force arrow. Alright, I'm not going to worry about that right now, because that's a timer. And generally, timers work better when you understand exactly what's going on. So I'm not going to worry about it right now. Let's try solving this room without the challenge first, so we can understand where the problem areas are. Obviously, some of the problem areas are we need to be able to approach certain places without getting overwhelmed. And also, that's an issue. Can't let that happen. Now, how am I going to deal with four tar babies? Alright, I think I want... Yeah, I need to exploit the spawning algorithm to get it to spawn the water skipper out there. Now I'll make a run for it. Hmm. Am I going to be able to turn around in time? No. I was two moves off. If I were facing northwest in this scenario, I'd be fine. And that happened pretty much immediately. So... But it seems like I need to deal with this section before I go here, because otherwise a wire skipper will get on this arrow, and that's just not going to be good for anybody. So maybe I need to do this section fast enough that this skipper doesn't get on this arrow, so it's okay if I get water skippers on this west side. Maybe. It's worth a shot. Admittedly, I got caught up with these guards here. I had to waste a lot of time at the entryway, which might be what these are for. Is to just slow me down in kind of an organic way rather than just outright having a hallway. But they are certainly pretty well placed. This is a better guard formation than normal. Is there any way I can force my way past? Sort of. Not especially well. Like, that's, like, basically the fastest I can go, and I've already let, because this diagonal is, like, already aligned with this water skipper, I've already let a water skipper on that arrow, which is bad news. Alright. Okay, so that's interesting, then. So that almost seems to imply I actually want to go around the south, then. So if I go, like, up like that, that'll drag that guard northwards. So maybe I need to hit that orb and then get out of there and then run to, like, if I could just get out of the way here. If that guard weren't... Okay. Is that going to be good enough? No, because the guard's going to follow me over there. And I can't get, like, right south here because of this one water skipper in the way. And I've attracted these tar babies from the top, so I can't really easily face southwest here. So that's the kind of... I think that's the kind of maneuver you would need in order to, get here in time to prevent that water skipper from getting on the arrow. I think it's possible. I think it's possible if I do it slightly better, but there's certainly a lot of compounding factors here that make this pretty rough. Wait a second. I could just be reading this wrong. Like, maybe I can just survive this even if the roaches do stack up to this extent, because can't I just face east and still handle them? I think that's movement order again. Like, maybe if they're all over there, then I could do it, but, not if there's any more than that. If there's any more over here, that seems real bad, and I don't think I can really fix that. Alright, well, we'll just take it from here. Like, I'm not sure I'm gonna be improving on that very much. So I guess this is what the author meant when he said light combat, huh? I mean, this is pretty intense, I gotta say. You know, this is by no means trivial. Alright, so what else can I do? This orb all the way out there is what shuts that off. But I can't hit that until I'm done with this west section here. I mean, this kind of central one. Gotta spawn it here. Uh, That's not quite... Well, yeah, that is actually fast enough. No, it's not, because I need to kill that single leftover water skipper. Like, if there wasn't one already on the Forsair, then I would be set here, but that's not quite good enough. Like, I almost feel like a guard is supposed to be helping me out here. Like, that's how short on time I feel, but I'm not quite actually there yet. So this is pretty rough. Like, eventually I'll be able to get in here and fix this. This part's not hard. This part I've got figured out. It's just there's something timing related that I'm not quite getting. Let me see if I can do the opening any better. It's kind of seems like it's set up not to be, because that's like... These are very advantageous positions for the guards to actually be in, as it turns out. Because their swords are covering pretty nice areas. That does seem to be the best I can do, and it's still not really fast enough. So I guess the last thing I've tried is I've just been assuming that I lose when I get to this point, but maybe I don't. Like, maybe I can recover this somehow, because a few more roaches will spawn down there. It's only going to be, like, two more, though, so it's not going to be a huge problem. So if I go, like, now, I might still be able to have a few enough in there that I can get to that orb someday. Like, can I survive that? That was... Yes, just barely. Of course, I haven't really dealt with the water skipper problem yet, and now I have a bunch of tar babies that have also built up, but might be able to... Ah, so close. I was hoping that, like, because that should make it easier. Like, if I can deal with this part without that happening, then it'll actually make this approach to the west section easier, because there won't be as many wire skippers waiting for me down there. But, geez, it's rough. Well, hold on a second. Maybe I can fix this by going south. Yeah, like, I'm killing them one by one by going down here. But maybe, yeah, by going south like that, that will give me just barely enough time to even out the water skipper spawns just a little bit so I can go back up. And then, like, turn around in time. Like, if this single tar baby were not here right now, I could go south... turn northwest and have enough time to fix this problem and that problem. That's how tight this is. Where did that one come from? It came from over there. Of course it did. Because those are already there and they're in good shape. Is there any way I can speed that up? Not really. The only way to really fix that is to not let three down there in the first place. Did I have time for that? Sort of? Yes. Yes, I did. Okay, so let's try that again with just one down there. That seems a lot better. Yeah, now I can just go down here immediately. Okay, now we're actually on track for the challenge. Because this is more or less stable. I can thin this out. We'll get that nest eventually. We should be able to get this one from going out of control, and we'll clean up the tar babies eventually. Because, yeah, this is... The only reason this works is because of the high efficiency of using the really big sword to kill things. If I had any other weapon, I don't think I could kill things fast enough to keep up with this. Let us still position ourselves carefully here, though, so we don't overdo it. Let's empty out that bucket so that, how did that happen? Oh, it's because I was standing, like, right on that diagonal. That is a shame. How's this gonna work? I guess I just need to kill these up here first. Alright, is this gonna do it? Yes, just barely. Wow. Okay. Alright, so that's how you do the challenge. And now that I've actually cleaned up this water skipper part, this part will eventually harass me, but that's okay. But everything else seems pretty standard from this point on. Okay, but see, it's, like, even though it was horde management, like, I just had to think of ways that I could improve my current position. And that's just really what it all boils down to. From here on, it's pretty standard tar cleaning. Oh, I didn't want that to happen. Yeah, that's a problem. Alright, fair enough. Guess I just won't let it happen then. And of course, the tar baby squad over here is ready to make my day miserable. Yeah, gotta sneak in stabs like that sometimes. That's an issue. I can't ever let that happen. Can't ever let that happen either. Yeah, this is very well constructed, actually. Yeah, like, I'm gonna have to dive in deeper, I think. Let's back up. I don't know. Okay, so I did hit that checkpoint. Yeah, so this is all solid. I can kill all these. Then make a run for it. And probably do that alright, except I need to be facing the other way. Alright, so I'll make that turn up there to let those in. Actually, hold on a second. Why do I ever... There's no reason for me to ever clear this tar blob out. I can just go around it. So if I use this tar blob here, those babies will stay in place and do what they need to do. So I'll just cut around them. There we go. Sometimes you gotta think smarter, not harder. So here's the other problem with that. I do actually need to cut that eventually anyway, because I need to stand on that square in order to cut that. But that's okay. I've bought enough time. I think I can handle that. Yeah, so I want the tar to grow, like, right now. Yeah, like that. Now I can deal with this part, and I should be able to get out of here and make that cut before those guys come in. Yes. Then I could turn around, do this, I'm gonna need to, yeah, I'm just gonna have to go for it now. Face, northeast and do that. There we go. That will grow eventually, but that's okay. Like, this is all fine. Yeah, I can recover out of that. Alright, so that section was actually a little bit more troublesome than I gave it credit for. That's certainly, that actually kind of reminds me of some specific tar formations from the AE days, but, it's fine, it works. How's this gonna work? I guess like that, actually. Need to clear that out, of course. Deal with those tar babies, and now we're in a good shape. Okay, there. Now, I don't think there's any other catches that I can think of, because now it's all cleared out. Now I can just go get my swords and transport them across the room. should be pretty standard. I already did that. Yeah, I just needed a new sword. Because I need a sword to kill the spider and break that wall. Okay, there we go. Alright, that was pretty tough. That's, as far as horde rooms go, I've played harder ones, but that one was certainly pretty demanding, especially for the challenge. It almost felt like I needed to get the challenge done in order to have enough time to do this middle section anyway, but maybe there was an easier way of handling it that I just couldn't think of. But definitely, like, the three different spawn areas that are all differently spaced out, the spawn up here, the spawn down here, and the spawn over there, all very well coordinated. This thing over here, like, it's weird. Like, it felt like there had to be a faster way to do it, but I guess that's kind of the point, is it's meant to be like a soft barrier that you're not sure how quickly you can get through, rather than just like a wall or a spindly path or some trap doors you have to drop that you know exactly how long that's going to take. So not really sure how I felt about that one, but definitely overall I think it was good. So I guess it worked all right. So what's left? Spear, maybe? Don't want to hit that. But I need to be able to... Oh, I don't want to push that, but I need to be able to... Yeah, I guess that's what's being asked for. Or something similar. I could have bumped it into the arrow as well. But yeah, dagger couldn't get through here. I don't think any of the other weapons would. So I think that's exactly what's called for. Which makes sense. It's a process of elimination. But it's good to double check yourself sometimes. Okay. So I think I need some corpses here. Okay. Now I need to actually stab these guys, which is going to be tricky with a spear. Yeah, I'm glad there aren't any more constructs up here. That's for sure. So let's see. Whatever move I make that is going to work, it's going to have to be quick. Yeah, like, I kind of felt like that was good because that was a full stun there. But that's still not quite right. There, that's good. Now I've got fewer constructs actually after me, so I actually have time to do stuff like this. I mean, I guess I could have just made it all the way around them and, let's see. Still had time. Alright, so... Yeah, this is definitely a mechanism for just getting, like, one at a time through like this. So that's the first part done. Now I need a keg over here. So I need a bridge, probably. So that's pointing to doing that... Well... No, we'll want to do that, because... Well, I need to still be able to actually kill the, seat, but that's probably gonna have to be good enough. I guess. Alright, what are the mirrors for, actually? Mirrors are probably needed for down here, if I had to guess. I mean, I guess we... Because there's, like, three different things that can make stepping stones here. And I'm still trying to figure out exactly which one goes where when. I don't think evil eyes can cross shallow water, but we might need the eyes for something as well. But certainly we need at least one keg here. So let's operate under the assumption that if we need constructs, it's probably only going to be one construct. Probably not going to be more than one. We're going to need him to cross the shallow water, though. So you get over here. Build the bridge like that. Like, that seems to be a start. Push you over there, sure. I'm not sure if I want it awake yet. Alright, now what have we got down here? Need something... Something here, that's pretty clear. And something there. So we need to open all these. And what is happening here? So we need to release all of them. So we probably want all three mirrors here. So we'll close all that. And then what? That's a fire trap. When does this open? It opens here. So why wouldn't I just want to hold this down with something? Probably a keg. Put something else here. Don't know what that's going to be. Probably a mirror. I mean, it doesn't really matter. This can do what? Oh, that's gonna... Yeah, that's just gonna light that. Oh, but that'll open that. But can't I just, can I just hold this down with something? I've got, like, a lot of things to use. I've got... In fact, I've got sleeping evil eyes. Well, it can't, couldn't be a sleeping evil eye here. Couldn't be evil eyes here, here, here. So that's kind of hard to see what we would need them for. But I'll leave them alive. I can kill them later. So it's seeming like... Do I ever get this stuff back? No. But we do get one more construct as well, so... Kinda starting to seem like we need him up here, because I'm having trouble finding other stuff for him to do down here. I don't see how we're gonna get him across this Ormite boundary. So it kinda feels like that's the only thing we can really constructively use him for. Alright, we'll be able to recover those, and then we have all this stuff. And, yeah, so we still need... What is it? If we put an awake evil eye here, then we can blow it up later with the help of a keg. Yes. So that's how we're gonna do this. We're gonna use awake evil eyes for those. Yeah, sure, fine. Wake up now. Yeah, let's actually do this a little bit more cleverly. This way. So that way we will get the plate suppress that we need. I don't think we need that last one. Alright, so then we just need mirrors here. And keg will go here, and we've got enough stuff, I think. I still don't see what we really... Oh, we need something here, though, actually. Yeah, we're gonna need something here. And, well, hold on. It can't be the keg, because that will get blown up. Okay, that's what that's for. So, construct corpse? No, that's not gonna work, because it can't go across here. Evil Eye is not gonna work because I can't get through it because it's facing west. But if I use the keg to block its vision, it's okay. Alright, there we go. That'll do it. Alright, as I suspected, every single object in the room plays a role, which is usually true. Sometimes it's not, but usually it is. Let's do this properly. So let us at least get the keg into position, I guess. Whoops. Okay, another problem. We need to put the eye somewhere. Yeah, we can't get it across this bridge without waking it up. So I put the construct corpse in the wrong place. Yeah, I needed it to actually be here. Like, I'll show you. It needs to be kill it here. push it up like that. This formation will work. Now he can actually get in a sleep evil eye past that. It's a little bit awkward, but we'll manage. How am I going to get in a sleep evil eye past this part, though? Like that. There we go. Now we can push it the rest of the way across. And, yeah, these guys can wake up, so that's fine. Just mic them up now. Sure, why not? Alright, fine. I'll put one mirror there and do the same trick I did the earlier, just because I don't see an easy way to just get them across without that. But that's okay. In fact, I'll even put a keg there so that the runway's a little bit cleaner. There we go. Stack them up nicely. Alright, fine. Guess this is a little bit harder than I gave it credit for. Maybe shouldn't have tried doing that all at once. Jeez, you try and save time, and look where it ends up with you. You run into unexpected difficulties. You just gotta keep things simple. Alright, so I guess the rest is just a matter of cleanup, then. Alright, so the eye will not get blown up because eyes are not explosive. The mirrors will do their job of being reflective. And, well, hold on a second. I don't actually want that to be open yet. It's fine. When the time comes, I will fix that. I can only push the mirrors, like, a certain speed. Like, I can only get two of them at once, and even then it's a little bit awkward. That's not so bad. Alright, points for at least a little bit of points of style, at least. Alright, that should be our final setup here. That seems to have done the trick. Alright, so our keg is not blown up, so we can use it for this part. The eyes will die. I can stand on the door. Everything's good. Okay. Alright. This part was a little bit awkward. I think movement order might have some play in it, but I figured because there was so little space here, there had to be some good move I could make to stab one of the constructs, and that would make my life a lot easier. So I got there eventually, and I guess that was an appropriate level of difficulty for that construct start there. And the rest was a really solid puzzle. Definitely, no complaints here, and it all just worked out really well. So I guess that's it. I mean, there might be a secret room or something, but I'm not going to worry about secret rooms until the end of the hold, probably. Just because there's, like, so much... they're just so easier to track once you've got that little counter that identifies where everything has to be. Alright, we successfully got the sword. So what could possibly be next? I guess roleplay? Sure, why not? We have to do it sooner or later. Guess we're gonna put on some costumes. Sure, so I guess this is the theater department then. Alright. I mean, Beethro always wanted to be an amateur actor, and luckily this Actors Guild is all too willing to impress. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, now we're a Wraithwing. We always wanted to be a bird and fly around. But as soon as we get up here, we have to be a Beethro again. Sure. Right. Where is the power token, in fact? Is it all the way up here? Now, of course, we're flying, so we can't be in water, but if we're a roach and we are powerful, yes, now we can traverse the water. Yes. Alright, well, I guess that makes sense. Kind of. Alright, well, I mean, I feel like I gotta read all this stuff, because it seems like it's gonna be really important. Oh, we've got some evil eyes here. That's what I need to kill. Oh, but I didn't need to kill them because this is just an empty room. So I guess those are characters too. I guess it's just the tutorial area. I guess that's fine. Right, that's good to know. Right, that makes sense. Right, so now that we've activated the power token, the soldier, which would normally be not waiting, like, it would not be invisible, he'd just walk around in shallow water like it was normal floor. He would be able to hit this with his sword. But now he can bump into it to open it. So let me just demonstrate that real quick, because this is important. This guy. Soldier. Can wade around in shallow water. Like this, which might be important. As it turns out. I guess we're just gonna have to see. Alright, so that should be everything we need to know. Hopefully this doesn't get real in-depth, but I guess we're just gonna have to see. Alright, well, this is the first room, so ideally it should be the simplest. So we start as a goblin. And I think, we are stealthy. Okay, that is good to know. Now, we will become unstealthy as soon as we kill something, but I don't see any way around it. Those will open eventually. So, yeah, I guess we're gonna have to do that and, alert everything. Guess we might as well kill all this stuff. Well, we can. Now we have not hit that power token yet, so right now the citizen is the only thing that can actually hit that orb. So it sounds like we want to borrow this mirror real quick. Do this. So is there anything else we can do? We need a sword to break those mirrors. Oh, and that's a one-way thing. Okay. Alright, so we can let that happen. Now, can we be a guard? Yes, we can. Probably don't need these anymore. I'll leave that there because we might need to open this door again. So now we can hit this. We haven't hit the power token yet, so we still aren't dropping trapdoors. And we can't get those mirrors out. Okay. So now we need to be the goblin again, but we can't kill those eyes without... Alright, so we probably need to... Alright, so now we'll drop trapdoors, and I guess that's it, then. Does anything else close this door again? No. Okay, so this door will just stay open then. Alright, we're fine. We can kill that. Seems like one of the flying rolls is going to be invaluable for us, because we can just use it to skip parts, like especially this part. And we've hit a power token, so we can go through the tunnel, even if we are a bird. Alright, so if this is what we are coming to expect, just, again, just kind of, like, lock possibilities that you need certain, certain costumes in order to get through, then I guess I can get behind that. I think I've got room to try out one more room in this episode. We'll see. If it goes long, I'll, cut it, but, we'll see. Okay, so we are a wubba that everybody knows about. Yes, that guard sees me. But fortunately, we are invulnerable, because we are a wubba. Now, what can we do about it, though? We still need to lure certain objects onto spots, so this seems to be due to order of operations. That seems to be the best way to start. Yeah, like that. So we'll probably want to just put things like evil eyes here. But we're gonna need a the help of an evil eye, like so. Like, in order to get that last plate filled, we're gonna need to do something like that, in fact. Like, something like that that doesn't actually kill that eye, essentially. Like that, actually? That should be pretty good. If I could just get it to go the other way, then we're fine. I mean, I guess we can manipulate the eye however we like, because it's not going to, actually eat us, because wubbas are not edible, but we still have the guard to worry about. That being since it moves before the eye does. Now, maybe we can actually just get the guard to move back and forth. Like that. There we go. Now we've got everybody on the plates at the same time, so that eye will come out. So now we can probably get rid of everything else. Yeah, that looks good. So how are we going to get an eye onto one of these plates? We're going to need the guard's sword to help out, I think, is how that's going to work. Because the guard can just be the last thing that gets onto one of these things. Yeah, there we go. And we can do this last part like we did the first part way back at the beginning. Get the guards on us. Do that. Oh, right. We're going to need the guard's sword to actually kill one of these eyes, in fact. The one in the center here. Like that. I should just be able to put the guard in here as long as I can make him face this way, like that. There we go. Alright, unusual, but again, still conforming to most DROD's concepts. This, the bit at the start where you need to know about eyes immediately waking up, if, like, this is an important trick to know is, knowing that plates don't release until the end of the turn, so there was still like a spot inside the middle of the turn where all three of those gates were open, which can be used either to player benefit or, you know, architect misery or architect benefit, in fact. So definitely intentional here, but you gotta keep a lookout for that kind of stuff. But I think the rest of the room is pretty self-explanatory. I needed to fiddle around a little bit to get this part working, but other than that, pretty standard. I mean, it's a little bit tricky to make a wubba puzzle, but this really worked out pretty well. Alright, well, so far I'm encouraged. I guess I'll take a peek into the next room, and then I'll leave it off. So, next time, will be a bird and do two different challenges. Well, maybe. We'll see.